Do you want to exactly know how to clean your acrylic paint brushes?
Hi, this is Madhula, the artist behind Madhula Creations.
And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to clean your acrylic paint brushes even when the paint has dried completely. From this to this. I have a lot of brushes and many of the brushes have lasted for years now. So let me share with you how I clean my brushes. I have divided this video into sections. The first section tells you how to clean acrylic paint brushes when you are painting. And in case you have not cleaned your brushes properly or let the acrylic paints dry on your brush, in the second section, I will show you how to clean dried acrylic paint brush. So feel free to jump onto your required sections. How to clean your acrylic paint brush during and after painting. You have to wash your brushes properly during painting and also after painting. Acrylics dries very quickly, right? So during your painting session, always keep washing your brush in clean water. When you are not painting, don't allow the paint to stay on the brush. Just wash it and keep it. When you are washing, don't push your brush against the floor of the container very strongly. This will damage the bristles. Instead, use both the sides and the floor of the container and wash the brush very gently. Also, observe the water level. When you place the brush inside the water level should not exceed the metal area. The longer you allow the brush to stand in water, the quicker the damage will be. So don't allow the brush to stay in water. Even few minutes will damage your brush. If you are a person who tend to leave the brush in water, then start practicing to wash, wipe and keep it on your work surface. After the painting session, I usually wash all the used brushes in soap and running water. You can use any soap for this. You can use a liquid soap like a hand wash or also dishwash liquid soap. You can also use a solid soap. The solid bar soap, I usually put it inside a container so it's very easy to use and store. There are also soaps available specifically for brush cleaning. I will link that in the description box below. After cleaning, just wipe the brush and keep it flat on the surface to dry. Don't keep it upright as the bristles may get damaged. Just allow it to dry flat. If you do this rightly and properly, your brushes will remain new for years together. However, there are times when we run for some errands leaving our brush with the paint, right? I had done it. Although now I'm very cautious not to do it, let's see how to clean dried acrylic paint brushes. I will give you different methods on how to clean your dried paint brushes, and depending on how tough your bristles have become, you might have to use one or more techniques. This is how my brush looks. Paint is dry completely. In method 1, I'm going to use only soap and water. But you have to use it multiple times to take off the paint completely. You can use hand wash or any other soap too. There is also soap specifically designed for brush cleaning, as I told you earlier. I'll link the link below. You can check that out too. So you can use any soap of your choice. Once the brush is in water for a minute or so, gently start pulling off the acrylic paint like this. You have to do it a couple of times before all of the paint just comes off the brush. You have to be still gentle with the brush. Do not pull it off with so much force. You might pull the bristles itself. Now, as you can see, the bristles have become very soft and manageable. Allow it to dry completely. There is still some fraying of the bristles, which I'll tell you how to get rid of later in this video. The second method is to use distilled turpentine. Here is the new one. It's a clear liquid. And here is the used one. Currently, a bottle costs you around 100 rupees. I'll link this in the description box below. You can actually reuse it multiple times before you can throw it off. I will take the used turpentine in a bowl. See these bristles here? It's very tough to move them. It is hard and dried with paint. Now let's dip the bristles inside it. You can see how the paint is coming off the bristles of the brush. Work on it for a couple of minutes and most of the paint will be removed. Now wash the brush thoroughly in soap and water and allow it to dry. You can restore the turpentine and use it later. As the paint residue increases in the bottle, you can just allow it to settle down at the bottom of the bottle and only take the top clear turpentine to use it later. The only disadvantage of this method is the strong odor of the turpentine. If you are going to follow this method, do it in a well-ventilated room or in your outside area. The third method is to use rubbing alcohol. This is also an efficient method to clean your brush. As compared to the turpentine, rubbing alcohol does not have much odor, but it is costlier than the turpentine. This bottle costed around 225 rupees. See this brush, it's so hard and I'm unable to move the bristles. I used an acrylic medium in this brush and have allowed it to dry completely. So let's clean this up. I'll take little rubbing alcohol in a bowl. Dip the brush and you will see how it is softening the bristles. Just move the bristles around for a couple of times and then you are done. Once done, as usual, wash it in soap and water and allow it to completely dry. You can also use the same rubbing alcohol to clean the other parts of the brush too. Just use a cotton ball, dip it into the rubbing alcohol and wipe the brush. This will give you a clean, shiny brush. These are some of the dried brushes after cleaning. So as you can see, the brushes has frayed and looks like a flower, right? Now let's fix this up. Take the soap. You have to use a solid soap for this. Add a touch of water and work on getting a layer of soap on the bristles. Do this couple of times so that the bristles are filled with soap. And just with your fingers, make the required shape of the bristle. Allow it to dry flat on the table like this. Leave it overnight or a day or so and then wash it. Here is the washed brush. See how much better it has become. So if your brush is starting to fray, you can do this every now and then or after every painting session. Sometimes you might not be able to fix it completely, so you might have to use those brushes for some other purpose. But to some extent, the fraying can be definitely fixed. I do post video tutorials with step-by-step instructions like this one, detailed product reviews and much more on my channel every week. So do subscribe and also click on the bell icon so that you get notifications from YouTube whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and if you got value from this video, do click on the like button and also do share it. Also, subscribe and let's stay in touch. I do have other acrylic painting tips and tutorials. Do check them out too. Have a great week and happy painting.